A real challenge in the care of cardiovascular patients is triple therapy, that is triple antithrombotic therapy, often consisting of aspirin, ethinopyridine, and warfarin. Exactly which patients should get it, which patients shouldn't get it. And that is really a dilemma. There are patients who, for example, have atrial fibrillation and a recent acute coronary syndrome, receive a stent, which is quite appropriate for the majority of patients with ACS, but then what do you do with that sort of patient? I think it's a very delicate calculus of weighing their ischemic risk and their bleeding risk, and that's easy to say, but to do in real life can be quite a challenge because most of the risk factors for ischemic events are the same risk factors for bleeding events. So in day-to-day clinical practice, that simple weighing can be quite difficult. But I do think there is some concrete ways to proceed when evaluating a patient who might need triple therapy. So I think the first step is to weigh the overall ischemic slash thromboembolic risk, how serious that is, and how strong the need is for warfarin. And that's sort of then just the anchor. Does the patient need warfarin or do they not need warfarin? And if they can have warfarin interruption, how long can it be interrupted? So in a patient, for example, with recurrent pulmonary embolus, probably not a good idea to take them off warfarin. In a patient who has a very strong indication like that for anticoagulation, let's say that patient comes in with an acute coronary syndrome. Well, first of all, it's a little bit concerning that they came in with an acute coronary syndrome, assuming they were therapeutically anticoagulated. And if anything, that tells me they really do have a thrombotic tendency or an atherothrombotic tendency. But in that sort of patient, I think I would go ahead and place a bare metal stent if they really did need a stent, avoid a drug-eluting stent, and use a minimum duration of triple therapy with aspirin, clopidogrel, and warfarin, maybe 2 to 4 weeks, depending on what their overall bleeding risk is. And again, if that same patient with recurrent PEs was a 50-year-old, 90-kilogram male, I'd be a little bit generous in terms of the duration of triple therapy, perhaps. A 50-kilogram, 80-year-old female with a bit of renal dysfunction, you know, there I would probably abbreviate the duration of triple therapy. So it really is a complex weighing of risks and benefits. I don't think there's any easy answer that fits every clinical scenario. There are some general principles, though, I think that are useful. I think if triple therapy is going to be used, assuming that's been a very conscientious decision to use it, I think a baby aspirin might reduce the risk of bleeding. So there's no harm with going with a baby aspirin for chronic therapy. I think if the patient is going to be on triple therapy for a protracted period of time, gastric protection is probably called for. That in itself has become a controversial topic as far as how to provide gastric protection. Proton pump inhibitors are probably the most potent way, but there has been some controversy around whether there might or might not be drug interactions with clopidogrel and proton pump inhibitors. But still, in a patient that's got a good indication to be on a proton pump inhibitor, and I think a patient on triple therapy falls into that category, I would personally still use a proton pump inhibitor. I would caution that patient on triple therapy to avoid non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, realizing that these patients that need triple therapy often have osteoarthritis or other indications for non-steroidals. And I would instead recommend alternative forms of pain management, things like acetaminophen, in particular at higher doses, assuming that there aren't problems with respect to liver function. So it really is a matter, I think, of weighing lots of different risks in a particular patient and being a complete doctor. So I don't think it's sufficient just to focus on the ischemic risks, the thromboembolic risks, the bleeding risks, the arthritic risks, the GI risks. I think it's a matter of weighing all those different factors and then individualizing therapy. I think right now triple therapy is really a great example of the art of medicine.